Blackstone Audio presents Battle, The Story of the Bulge, by John Toland. This book is read by Dan Butler. This book is dedicated to all those who were there. Author's note: this is the documented story of the greatest pitched battle ever fought by the United States, its only major struggle in the dead of winter. It was as great in scale as the Battle of Stalingrad. Over 1 million soldiers and thousands of civilians were actively involved. Unlike any other campaign in World War II, it was conceived in its entirety by Adolf Hitler. It was his last great offensive, his last great gamble. The dialogue in this book is not fictional. The conversations were reported to me by participants or listeners. For example, the retort of McAuliffe to the German surrender request at Bastogne, suspected by many of being Bowdlerized, was told to me by 5 men who were present. For over 2 years, I followed the trail of the Battle of the Bulge. It led to interviews with more than 1,000 people in 10 countries. To make myself familiar with the sprawling battlefield, I walked over many miles of the Ardennes. I slept in foxholes and in cellars. I retraced scenes of battle and murder with civilian eyewitnesses. Often, and spontaneously, these people of Luxembourg and Belgium would suddenly reenact what had taken place so many years before with harrowing realism. This book could not have been written without the full cooperation of the departments of the Army and Air Force. They opened their files and tracked down the whereabouts of Bulge participants without making a single demand or restriction. They had only one request: that I tell the truth. Part 1. Operation Christrose. Chapter 1. The Ghost Front. 15 December 1944. 1. The night of December 15th, 1944, was cold and quiet along the Ardennes front. At 10 p.m., the American troops in Echternach, a quaint medieval town in the Grand Duchy of Luxembourg, were abed, or going to bed, in yellow patrician houses with dormer windows and mansard roofs. They saw no sign of activity from the Germans in the crumbling clifftop abbey that overlooked them from across the swift, narrow, sour river. They had nothing to stay up for in Echternach itself. Since September, when the Americans had liberated Luxembourg at the end of their wild dash through France, the town's 3,300 citizens had been living in evacuation quarters behind the hills to the west. Echternach, the southern anchor of the Ardennes front, was being held by a single company of riflemen, and by 10:30 p.m., all but a few of them were asleep. Twisting 85 miles through terrain reminiscent of the Berkshires and the Green Mountains, the front was held by 6 American divisions. Of these 6, 3 divisions were brand new and had been sent here to get blooded, lightly tested in combat before being assigned to a major engagement. The other 3, exhausted and bled white in battle, were here to be refitted, retrained. For the Ardennes front was the Ghost Front, a cold, quiet place where artillery was fired mainly for registration and patrols probed the enemy lines only to keep in practice. Within rifle range of each other, German observers watched the Americans eat, and the American observers watched the women come at dusk and steal into the pillboxes of the Siegfried line. For over 2 months now, both sides had rested and watched and avoided irritating each other. From Echternach, the front swung northward along the winding Zauer River. The hill-straddling American lines were manned by the 4th Division, which the month before had suffered 7,500 casualties in the brief but bitter battle of Hürtgen Forest. On the German side of the river, the battlement-like cliff continued, concealing the forward positions of the Siegfried Line. About 5 miles north of Echternach, the 9th Armored Division took over. Newly arrived in Europe, it had been in position for just a week. Actually, only one combat command, roughly equivalent to an infantry regiment, was on the line.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.